lead us in the prayer for that.
Father, again, we just thank you for the time you give us, Lord. Thank you for letting us come here, get some doctrine, take care of the county business, and watch over, help us do the right thing for the county. Bless our fire, please, and our soldiers and stuff, Lord, as they protect us. Watch over our schools, Lord, we're very praying for them at this point in time, but watch over and help them, help us make the right decisions for our children. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Clerk.
Commissioner Thompson.
Here.
Commissioner Cutler.
Here.
Chairman Kinnear.
Here.
Commissioner Winter.
Here.
Commissioner Long.
Here.
At this time, are there any items to add or remove from the agenda? Do I have a motion to approve the agenda as is?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Has everyone had a chance to look over the minutes of the February 20th meeting? And if so, do I have a motion to approve?
So moved.
Second. All in favor of approving the minutes for the February 20th meeting, say aye.
Aye.
Do we have any appearances at this time? Any appearances at all at this time? No, I'm sorry, sir.
Y'all got to do that just a little quicker. My name is Paul Ross. I'm at 216 Starlight Lane, Ringo, Georgia, in Gray County, Kentucky. I really love it. I've been here about 15 minutes. I don't know how government's running anymore. I went to one 50 years ago and spoke about a highway. But it's been laying heavy on the heart of our school. I have two things about our school. I don't feel that we need to wait for any other government to protect our children. Years ago, I thought that they took little tax measures and built libraries and stuff. I feel that we should investigate that and maybe float a little penny tax, 2 cent tax or something, where we can put metal detectors in our schools. You can't go in the courthouse, you can't go in other places without a policeman or a metal detector in there. I feel that we need to put our children above everything else, libraries, homes, everything. They are our future. And one other thing about the schools is my grandson's biggest excuse is when he misses the bus, when they change buses, he don't know which bus to get on because he's either in gym or getting here. He's 15 years old, he's there. And they go, if we could come up with some kind of a metal plate that magnetizes over the old school bus number for when that school bus is doing the run for another school bus, they could put the number on it, so he won't have that excuse. I don't have to give him the money. It's about far as me. And that's about it. I just came in to see maybe y'all get ahead of the ball on this, not wait on the states or the federal government to do something. Let's just take care of our own. Yeah, thank you for this.
Mr. Ross, thank you.
Thank you.
Took me a while to get
here. Anybody else have anything they'd like to say? This time we'll move on to administrative fiscal matters. Travis Hornby.
Thanks for having me tonight. I
come to you about the sale of the Toro infield rake. We are proposing selling it to Heritage High School. We are in the market for a new rake, the one we, the Toro rake that we're looking to get rid of when I got here. It had sat mostly unused, and it's ineffective in what we needed to do. The school system said they could get use out of it. They wanted it. They offered us money more than the trade-in value. And I looked at it, so we can offer it, and actually, we're going to replace that piece of equipment.
Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Any questions, Mr. Parker?
Mr. Chairman, I have a question. Mr. Burby, I appreciate the fact that you're trying to make money for the county. But I feel just a little guilty taking money from the school system when we could just sell it, whatever cost it. So I guess I would like to sell it for, if it's worth $5,000, sell it to them for $5,000. I mean, I don't know what the others feel like, but.
That's fine.
It's just a thought.
Initially, I had hoped to use that towards purchase of doing, and Carl, we worked out this, not really how it works, so. Whatever you guys say, I'm happy.
That saved them considerable amount of money versus buying a new one, I guess.
Yes, sir. A new one would run $12,000 to $13,000.
Carl, and you worked on my list, everything.
Yeah. The trade-in allowance was $5,000. And so, you know, the school did offer $6,000, so whatever you all negotiate.
I guess at this point, we just had to vote and decide. We do change it. We already have a motion.
Amend the motion if you want to change it.
Does anybody want to amend the motion?
I'll amend the motion that we buy it for whatever the value is.
Sell it?
Sell it, I mean, not buy it, sell it. For $5,000.
Do I have? We have amendment, second. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Chris, load a claim on check.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The Dixon County Economic Development Authority has received a presentation from GIS WebTech for software that enables demographics designed specifically for economic development and site selection needs. This software will allow Dixon County and the Economic Development Authority to host on the Dixon.com website an interactive map that will allow anyone to pull demographic and infrastructure reports from any point in Dixon County. This software is being presented to Dixon, Walker, Bay, and Chattooga Counties by the Joint Development Authority with a proposed two-year contract with subsequent annual contract renewals. The cost is $2,500 per year, but Talbot, Georgia is subsidizing $1,000 of the annual cost. So that the actual cost of the county is $1,500 per year. In February, at its meeting on February 13, 2018, the Economic Development Authority found that software would be a useful and beneficial tool for economic development for the Dixon County, and it was a worthwhile expense, especially since a portion of the deal is subsidized by Talbot, Georgia. The EDA does not have funding in the current approved budget for the $1,500 annual dues. And funding is available from existing GIS lodged funds, since the software will also enhance the county's already existing GIS system. The EDA unanimously passed a resolution recommending that the Board of Commissioners authorize funding for the software and authorize the Economic Development Authority to enter into a contract with GIS WebTech
Jeff. Josh and Randy with RPC. For the past year, Catoosa County staff been working with RTC to upgrade technology throughout the county. As the upgrades were implemented, we noticed the need for to cover security and also the use of Catoosa County information systems and IT equipment. The most efficient and cost-effective manner to accomplish this would be the migration to one domain. All county offices that have access to fiber, this option would be available to migrate this one domain. And to help accomplish this, staff with the help and guidance of RTC has written an acceptable technology usage policy. This policy would supplement and be in addition to the current county IT policy that's in the employee handbook. And each user group, which would be required to accept the conditions and comply with the usage policy before they can be allowed to migrate to the domain. And we've got, we currently have the sheriff that's on the currently in place, and we're looking at working on the courthouse departments as well as administrative offices. And it's been an eye-opener. So we've come a long way in the last year. So we still have to work with it. And I've got these guys here that certainly capable of answering any questions you might have about that process.
Do I have a motion?
So moved. Second.
Do we have any questions for the gentleman? On the district briefing stuff, this is this whole, I guess, 5 pages of stuff, and other district we were talking about.
Yes.
Has it been shown to the elected people or judges or anything? Have their opinion on it?
It's been available for several months now and been circulated. It's been out on the website, and most of the departments have already started working on those levels of access that they are needing.
Thank you. Any other questions? All in favor of this?
Aye.
Yes, James is in training.
This is the Dittany Bowes postage meter that tabled at last meeting of lack of details. The meter is a larger meter than what the sheriff has, plus it's automated rather than a manual feed. And the planning and zoning building inspection runs quite a number of, quite a volume of items through that machine. It's running about $5,000 for postage a year. So you could look at 10,000, 11,000 items going through it. So that's the reason for needing the automated feed rather than the manual feed. And it is a price increase in that particular machine had not had price increase in 10 years. And that was a price increase effective November of 2017, which raised the price approximately $78.
Do I have a motion for approval?
So moved.
Second.
Do we have any questions for Brad? All in favor?
Aye.
This time we have no new business. Do we have any commissioner comments?
I'd just like to thank everybody for coming. Thanks, RTC, for your hard work making this online better. And I'd like to wish a special birthday wish to a, do I dare say,
No, are you up?
Just a smidgen over 39, how's that? So happy birthday. So thank you all for coming.
Thank you, everyone. Any other?
Leadership.
We have you by some leadership if you're sitting here. Would y'all stand up and introduce yourself? We'll start with you.
I'm Jill Brindle. I'm with Environmental Solutions.
Christina Sizemore with Capital Bank.
Pedro Mueller with the Chattanooga Area Food Bank.
Penny Mahon with Habitat for Humanity of Cadiza County.
Jason Hooper, Shaw Industries.
Thank y'all very much and this patient. At this time, we're going to go into executive session for legal and personnel. Clerk, would you call the roll?
Commissioner Thompson?
Yes.
Commissioner Cutler?
Yes.
Chairman Henry?
Yes.
Commissioner Winter?
Yes.
Commissioner Long?
Yes.
This time, do I have a motion to come out of executive session?
Second.
All in favor of coming out of executive session, say aye.
Aye.
Move into open session. We have one item. Skip.
Yes, sir. Mr. Chairman, what we have is the board approval of a contract terminating the contractual agreement between Catoosa County and James M. Walker Jr., a mutual release covenant not to sue and confidentiality agreement. The agreement provides that Mr. Walker resigned his position as county manager of Catoosa County, Georgia. He resigned on February 20, 2018, terminated his employment on that day. As a part of the settlement with Mr. Walker, the county has agreed to pay him the sum of $54,000, which includes all of his accrued leave, all of his accrued sick pay, and in all of his salary up to the point of termination. There is a confidentiality agreement and a non-disparagement agreement that's mutual. There is also a total mutual release and covenant not to sue, that we don't, will not sue Mr. Walker. Mr. Walker will not sue us. That he's resigned, he's moved on, and Catoosa County has accepted his resignation and the county's ready to move on.
Do I have a motion to approve?
So moved.
Second.
Do we have any questions? Of course, here. All in favor of accepting this, say aye. adjourn?
So moved.
Second. All in favor of adjourn, say aye.
Aye.
Thank you.